Quite a funny question. I would choose a cat.
Now it gets really difficult.
But this is a very untypical question to a lawyer. Yeah?
Hi, everyone. Welcome to another Worlds of Law video. Those of you who read my blog know that last winter, I took a long trip through Europe. In between giving talks and teaching classes, I made a point of speaking with lawyers, young legal scholars, and law professors about their work. I brought my video camera. I was just beginning to use it. These were high-level professionals, some at the very top of their field, and the conversations that we had were mostly about technical legal issues. But as an experiment, I also posed some questions to these very serious people that required them to give answers that were, well, playful, and they were kind enough to go along. I asked them to compare their legal systems, or those they knew best, to animals, music, tools, modes of transportation, to all kinds of things that have nothing to do with law. If your legal system were a sport, for instance, what kind of sport would it be?
It's almost like I'm with a psychologist, you know. I'm just going to say to you what comes to mind.
That was the idea, to have lawyers say just what came to mind. A little bit like a Rorschach inkblot test. I hope their answers would reveal something about their different legal systems. The similarities of many of their responses was striking.
Why would I choose it? Because cats can be away for a couple of days but come back again. It's kind of like the same with the law. Whenever you need the law, you grab it, take bad things out that you need. On the other hand, you just let it be where it is, maybe ignore it.
I was thinking about an old tiger, formerly having been strong but sleeping a lot.
I would choose a pencil because with a pencil, you draw all these lines and you draw up a system. It's like law to regulate society. But also, with a pencil, you can draw these lines with separate.
It's funny because, I mean, a saw, you associate it with bringing about something. You know, people use a saw to cut a tree or to make something. So that thing, that aspect, and then the jig saw, because...
abstract art, but more colors that fade into each other.
You can compare it to abstract art, specifically Vasily Kandinsky. His later work is very abstract and it involves a lot of colors and a lot of textures, and it's almost kind of slurry. And well, Dutch law is in a way a kind of slurry of domestic law and international law.
Hey, I would say Swiss Army knife.
The Swiss Army knife.
There are so many tools in there. There are so many tools in this one particular thing. Has almost a solution for every problem, one could say.
Yeah, I was talking to a young German lawyer in Würzburg. He said German law is like a Swiss Army knife. Do you know what a Swiss Army knife is? Mm-hmm. He said because there's a solution for every problem.
Well, that's a very intelligent answer. Good scholar.
One of the things that I liked about this experiment was the chance that it gave people to articulate a deep understanding of what their law was all about. Often their ideals were profoundly different from those of my own country, to which they frequently drew comparisons. The people that I spoke to know American law well and admire it, but they also take their own path. Here are expressions of legal self-understanding from Germany, Austria, and the European Union.
What kind of machine is most similar to German law? Well, it must be a very complicated machine. I would say not a simple machine, perhaps a computer. In Germany, we often compare American law to a revolver, and it said the American lawyer is the Nachfolgeinstitution, yeah, of a revolver. In Germany, it's not so. We would perhaps say it's a computing machine. Yeah, it's a big machine. There's even a famous saying of a lawyer, Rudolf von Jering, who talked about Haarspalte Maschinen, which means in English machines for splitting up hairs. And he compared the legal system of his time to people who would be splitting up hairs. He said this with a critical undertone.
It would be a plier to me, because I would say that the law, the function of the law, is to regulate or somehow to counterbalance bad actions by the people. And so if you were to take a hammer who hits a nail in the wall, and maybe the nail is a little crooked, or the nail is too far in the wall, the law, the legal system would be the pliers, which were to take out the nail and put it in the right position and to be this corrective element in the whole procedure.
No, it's, as I said, it's like psychology. It's like something that burbles up. In that the Impressionist is all nicely done. It's trying to be realist. It's not these grand ideas. I'm Dutch, I think of Van Gogh. It's definitely not Van Gogh. This broad strokes and this little bit bordering on the crazy. Craziness, genius at the same time. That's maybe more the founding fathers. You know, we the people, we hold these truths to be self-evident, and you know, there they go. That is definitely not the case when you look at the European treaties, when you look at the Court of Justice, when you look at the whole European legal machinery. Well, so the Les Impressionistes. Yeah, that's it's funny. I haven't thought about it. Geez, what a question! But the more I think about it, the more I think, yeah, that's maybe an answer. Yeah.
Another fascinating thing about my conversations was how often a single person articulated the same idea again and again, but through different metaphors. This was especially the case when the person I was speaking to knew about my questions in advance, but it was true across the board. One of the basic characteristics of Dutch law is its wide range of contemporary and historical influences.
The Dutch are well known for their painters, Rembrandt, Van Gogh. We have also, from the same period, a very well-known painting in the Netherlands, but not so much in abroad, Panorama Mesdag. It is placed in The Hague, and it's amazingly big. It's more than 10 meters wide. It's a show of a town behind the dunes and the sea, and that's typical Dutch. We're, for most part of the Netherlands, is below the surface of the sea. So we build dikes. We stay behind the dikes and hope for the best. We fight against the water to stay and to keep it out. And it's also, we try to keep our legal system as much Dutch blended in with international law, but still keeping our identity as Dutch. Then I would think of the Toyota Prius.
Dutch law is a hybrid.
Exactly, it's a hybrid. International, national, keeping it together. I chose a beaver.
And that's a very sweet beaver.
Exactly. We're going to a future federal system in Europe. That's almost inevitable. But we again, as Dutch, really want to try to keep our national identity and our national legal system. The beaver is also about building dams. We build the dams to keep the water afloat.
Just as my questions brought out differences between Europe and the United States, so they also brought out differences within Europe itself. I think they also highlighted one particular country's sense of its legal identity. If your law were music, what kind of music would it be?
The civil code in Austria, it's very complex in its language and it's very old-fashioned. So I would say it would be a piece of music, maybe something from Beethoven, which is very heavy and very difficult to really understand or to get used to it. So really complex. But in the constitutional law, our constitution dates back from 1920, so it's a modern constitution. The wording is very modern, and it's something, it makes it much easier to work with it than with the civil code. So I would say our constitution would rather be a pop song, something that is easy to be listened to and you can easily follow and easily understand.
I would compare it to pop music.
Why?
Because it's not considered very valuable.
Yeah, very slow going, but steady going. So I'm thinking of the Bolero by Ravel.
Perhaps Bach.
Tell me why.
Well, because of the clear structure, or at least the attempt to have clear structures, generally ordered. Yeah, it tries to be harmonious, and perhaps it's also successful in being harmonious in a general sense.
If we look at the German constitution, it's almost like Bach.
Classical music, because there is some strict set of rules, probably some Bach.
Bach.
Every German I've asked has given the same answer.
That's interesting. Yeah? I think you could start by saying what it is not, and it is not Bach.
Here's one more, a window onto European legal development, onto the people making it happen, and onto the ideals that they bring to their work. I wonder where Americans would come down on this one. If your law were a mode of transportation, what kind would it be?
It would be a tram.
Why a tram?
A bit packed with people, not that pleasant. It's a bit difficult to see yourself through it.
What do Romanians hope? What kind of mode of transportation do Romanians hope their law will become?
High-speed train.
I think a very fast train, because society is increasingly getting faster and faster, and law needs to adapt to society in a way.
A train. It's very straightforward, very reliable as well, and it doesn't stop as often, so it keeps on developing.
I want to take the train.
Probably train.
Why not a bus?
A bus seems to me too ordinary in a way, too slow in a way, and yeah, too ordinary wouldn't be a great comparison.
Criminal code could be a Porsche. I would think of cars. The criminal code is quite short, good structure, sharp, fast.
Would be a marathon, because it's quite slow, but I'm hopeful that it's going to reach its goal.
So how much does the inner life of European law, its ideals, correspond with reality? What do these questions really get at? What do they allow us to see, and what kind of conversations do they allow us to have?
And would you say it really is like Bach, or is that just the ideal?
Of course, it's the ideal, and I mean, if you ask legal professionals, professors, what about especially the new legislation, and compared to this traditional legal bodies from the 19th century, you would always say, okay, the contemporary legal legislation is not that elegant, that abstract, not so much to the point. They're producing like vast texts, naming every exception that could possibly be thought of in reality. They try to do this, of course, it's impossible to do it. So of course, in the end, it's not Bach, but the idea of it, definitely.
And there is one more aspect. Sometimes, or quite often, Austrian trains are delayed. And that's also like things happen in real life, but it takes a long time until there are the legal norms that regulate those real things in life.
You agree?
Cool. I don't know if I would agree. It's a very nice picture.
It's a good picture in theory.
As high-level professionals, the people I spoke to were extraordinarily generous with their time, their openness, and with their willingness to have a bit of fun in order to get at something serious. If you'd like to take part, send me an email, Or better yet, wherever you're from in the world, try out some of the questions I posed and post a response on my blog.
Oh, it's definitely a mammal, I'd say. It's not a bird. It's not a bird. Oh, it's a mammal. It's a mammal.
Definitely. Why is it a mammal?
I think that any legal system is a mammal. It has its justiciable. It's a mammal.
Well, and we're just going to see what these are like. It may be that they don't work, but I think, in fact, that over here, let me turn this off.
No one talking all by myself. No one walking. I'm happy on the show, babe. Ain't misbehaving. Saving my love. I say love you. Really, they love you. I know it's saying one I love.